Hello students, welcome to Smart Engineering Tutorials. Today we are going to see another topic of Unit 1, that is Mathematical Models for Communication Channels. And this topic is not in the syllabus of CS students, but yes, it is in the syllabus of EC students, EEE and IT. So we have already discussed the different communication channels in our previous videos. And now we want to establish some mathematical equation for the different communication channels available. So, why do we need these mathematical models or equations? Actually, when we set up a communication system, then we require that which type of physical channel we are going to deal with and how can we analyze and design the transmitter and the receiver part of the communication system. For this thing, we have to have some kind of model which can describe the various characteristics of our communication channel. For this very purpose of analysis and design purpose of our communication system, we require these mathematical equations. Hence, moving further, it is convenient to construct mathematical models which reflect the most important characteristics of the transmission medium, which is the physical channels. These mathematical models for the channels are then used in the design of the channel encoder and modulator, which is in the transmitter, and of the demodulator and the channel decoder at the receiver. So here when we have already discussed about the block diagram of the communication system, we haven't seen the term channel encoder and channel decoder. Actually, these two terms have reverse characteristics of each other, and these are used in basically digital communication, where the encoding of the message is done at the transmitting end, and similarly the decoding part is done at the receiver end. So for this reason, this is a part of the transmitter and channel decoder is a part of the receiver, but they come into picture only in digital communication. In analog, there is no use of them since there is no coding. Now, the channel models which are frequently used to characterize the many of the physical channels available for use, out of those, the mainly used channel models are discussed below, and they are basically three types. The first one is the additive noise channel. This is the most commonly used and it is the simplest of the all three mathematical models. So here, as we can see the block diagram, there is the channel here in the center. The channel is the medium through which the transmitter is going to send the information from the source to the destination. So this is the channel, and on the left we have the transmitted signal ST, and on the right we have the received signal RT. So this is the transmitting end, this is the receiver end, and within the channel there is a noise NT which adds up to the transmitted signal and is sent to the receiver as a sum of the transmitted signal and the noise which is generated in the channel. So I have redrawn the diagram again here. So here, as you can see, the transmitted signal ST, the channel, and this NT is a random noise process. We call it a random noise process because you cannot determine beforehand that what kind of the noise will be. So it is defined as a random noise process, and this random process will come in later on in some video. I'll share it, that what these are random processes. So at the receiver end, we receive a signal RT, and what it is? It is the sum of the transmitted signal along with the this noise NT. So here in this model, the transmitted signal ST is corrupted because the signal itself is not being transmitted. It also takes with itself some noise, so it becomes corrupted. So this ST is corrupted by an additive random noise process NT. Now we will say that from where this noise comes into picture. This additive noise process may arise from electronic components, the circuits which are present in the system, and the amplifiers which are used at the receivers of the communication system. Or they can also, this noise can also come from interference during the transmission process. So if we are talking about this NT, if this noise NT is primarily because of the electronic components or the amplifiers of the receivers, then it is called with the name of thermal noise. There are many types of noise. Since that chapter is not being covered right now, so I'll just give you the name thermal noise for the noise being generated from electronic components and the amplifiers at the receiver. They're called thermal noise. And this thermal noise is statistically characterized as a Gaussian noise process. And for Gaussian noise process or any Gaussian process, it is spectrum is drawn like this. It has a peak in the center and then it has a very small values which is not considered. So this is a Gaussian wave shape. So this thermal noise is characterized as a Gaussian noise process. And the mathematical channel model which is defined for this Gaussian noise process is called as the additive Gaussian noise channel. And this channel model applies to a broad class of physical communication channels because most of the channels come under this category. And hence, it is mostly used in communication design and analysis part. Now, this is a very common channel model, and this is also of importance since if the signal being transmitted undergoes some sort of attenuation, then the modification in the channel model can be easily incorporated. As we can see here, if the signal undergoes attenuation in the transmitter, then the received signal, that is the RT, it can be modified. How? We had the equation ST plus NT, but now since attenuation is there, so the signal ST is multiplied by the attenuation factor. So this attenuation factor easily incorporated in the equation and we get a modified channel model. So this is the commonly used mathematical model. Now the second type is the linear filter channel. And this linear filter channel is, as you can see the name, it is linear, means there are no higher order terms here, it is linear, and filter is also being used. So in this type of channels, some sort of filter is going to be used, and when the filter comes into picture, its impulse response also comes into picture. So there are some physical channels which are bandwidth limited. Bandwidth limited means you cannot transmit a signal with a higher bandwidth than the prescribed for that particular channel. For example, the wireline telephone channels. And the filters used in these type of channels, they are used to restrict the bandwidth of the transmitted signals in order to avoid interference among the different signals being transmitted through the channel. So, such channels are characterized mathematically as linear filter channels. So, linear filter channels, but noise is always there with additive noise. We cannot remove this noise from the system. So, the block diagram for this type of channels, that is the linear filter channel with additive noise, we have already seen in the last diagram, there was transmitted signal, channel, with a noise NT, and then the signal was being transmitted and received at the right hand side. But here the one extra thing which you see is the linear filter, and this linear filter has an impulse response of CT, and this is the channel. So the channel output now in this case will be RT, that's the received signal, is equals to the transmitted signal convolved with the impulse response of this filter. So, the convolution of ST and CT will give you the output of this linear filter, and then the output is added to this NT, that is the noise, and then send to the receiver. So how we'll write? ST convolution CT plus NT. So the convolution of ST and CT, how it is written? Minus infinity to infinity C tau S T minus tau D tau plus NT. So this is the output which you will get in this case. And here CT is the impulse response of the filter. So these were the two types, and in my next video I'll be discussing the third type, that is the linear time variant filter channel. So thank you, and subscribe to my channel for further notifications.